हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम अगेन टू प्लैनेट टू सोल एस्ट्रोलॉजी। सो वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द सेम सीरीज ऑफ राहु केतु टुडे। सो वी वर ऑलरेडी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द डिफरेंट योगास फॉर्म ड्यू टू राहु एंड केतु इन द चार्ट। वी टॉक्ड अबाउट चांडाल योग ऑफ जुपिटर एंड राहु। वी टॉक्ड अबाउट महालक्ष्मी ऑफ अगेन जुपिटर एंड राहु। दैट मीन्स इफ राहु इज इन 10th और राहु इज इन 6th एंड if Rahu is in 6th and Jupiter is in 10th, it forms a Mahalakshmi Yoga. Native gets good wealth in that yoga. So another very famous and very important yoga formed in the chart is of Jupiter and Ketu, which is also called as Ganesh Yoga, and more it should be called as Upasana Yoga. So what happens in this yoga, such natives can become or are becoming very good sadhak, very good upasak of any shastra or of any spirituality they are following. Or if they are doing yoga abhyas, they will be very good in yogas. If they are following any occult sciences, they will be very good in that upasana or that sadhana. But only thing that as per the Ketu's nature, these people are never satisfied with their upasana. They always find something lacking in their sadhana. Even though their guru they meet in their life, still they will not be satisfied, or still they will not believe that yes, this person is my guru, or they will not accept the fact very easily because they are always in searching mode. And after searching, they get so detached, as Ketu's major feature is of detachment. After lingering for such a long period for anything, the bhav where Ketu is placed, or for the karakatva of the bhav where Ketu is placed, after all, this person is getting detached. No, now I am fed up of this. I'm not getting anything, so just I'm leaving it now. Give up. They have tendency of giving up. Let it be. If it is not happening, first they will run, then they will give up. So this is Upasana Yoga. Now another yoga very important in the chart is of Chandra Rahu or Shukra Rahu in the chart or Shani Rahu in the chart. So why this is called as Rudra Yoga? Rudra means very angered. This is a Rudra Roop of Shankarji, Rudra Roop of Shivji. Means Shivji were in anger mode. They were fighting mode. But in this yoga, in common people's chart, what happens? Such natives have tendency of making fuss or making quarrel here and there. Not a single day will pass without making any quarrel with anybody in this native's life. Particularly when Chandra Rahu or Shukra Rahu is there, and in next house if Saturn is placed, you will definitely see such natives are of quarrelsome nature. Or even though full day is passed very peacefully, these people will take out some or other reason and they will make a fuss, or they will fight with anybody related. So this is a Rudra Yoga. Another yoga is of Chhatra Yoga. What is Chhatra Yoga? Apart from any one planet, if all planets come under these nodes of Rahu and Ketu, it is called as Chhatra Yoga. But this Chhatra Yoga is called very good yoga if any Shubha planets are in Yuti between Rahu and Ketu. If Ashubha planets are in Yuti in this Chhatra Yoga, what will happen? That native will not have Chhatra means who is looking after. Chhatra means like a big umbrella of father. Father is like an umbrella who is looking after the family or forefathers or any elderly person in the house. So such people are not getting any fruits of getting any good results of father's love or father's support or something if any Ashubh Yuti between Rahu and Ketu. So this is Chhatra Yoga. Now one more yoga, very important yoga we have to see is Kapati Yoga in the chart. What is Kapati Yoga? Whenever from Lagna or from Chandra, if Saturn is placed in fourth bhav, it is called as Kapati Yoga. So what happens here, if this Saturn is not aspected by any beneficiary planet or any Shubha planet, this native will bluff people, or he will be bluffed by other people. Otherwise also Saturn and Chandra, both when they are in Kendra to each other, they always create a tendency of struggle, Sangharsh Yoga. Always negative thinking comes in their mind. So these are the few yogas formed because of Rahu and Ketu. Then another yoga, Shukra and Ketu, if you see, we can say it is a Daivi Dosh in the chart. It is also said that if Shukra and Ketu are together, the person has come with the curse of Devi. Or we could say that in his or her past karmas, he was lacking in Devi Upasana. So in this life, he has to do too much Upasana of Devi. Other than that, Shukra Ketu Yuti gives good wealth to the native. If this Shukra is placed in Ashwini Nakshatra, in first charan, so Ashwini Nakshatra first charan will be of Mars, second charan will be of Venus, third charan will be of Buddha, that is Mercury, and fourth charan will be of Moon. So if it is in first or fourth charan Ashwini Nakshatra Venus, definitely native is going to get good house or good wealth in his life in its Dasha Antar. Other than that, Shukra Ketu can give weird physical desires to the native. This we should always remember. Now here where this Yuti is placed, that also plays very important role. If it is placed in 12th bhava, the fruits will be more enhanced here. Or if it is placed in 5th bhava, then also you can see the fruits are more seen in bad side. Now if with this Shukra Ketu, if Uranus is placed, then person goes for homosexuality or same sex relations. So such Ketu plays here important role with Venus. So now we discussed about the different yogas in the chart. Now what we will do, we will take Rahu first and its Dasha. So in Rahu Mahadasha, Rahu is also called as Amrutchur. Rahu is also called as Bhogi, Vilasi, okay. Sahikya is his original name, Rahu's original name. He is Asur, Danav. So many names are given to Rahu, but only one plus point is that he did Amrut Prashan. So he has the ability to give all good fruits, all charam sima means highest pick fruits to the native in term of health, wealth, social values, means media people. See, if you see media people, if you see politicians chart, you will always find in their chart that Rahu and Chandra are in very good yogas, that is Rahu and Chandra are in trine or are in 311 yoga in the chart, either in natal chart or in D9 chart. But always you find Rahu and Chandra, if by birth are placed in good yoga or in transit also, if Rahu and Chandra comes in trine, it will definitely give limelight to the native. In any form it can be. So Rahu has the ability to give so much big fruits. All the hero heroines, all the media people, producers, directors, actors, backstage artists, makeup months, everything comes under Rahu. And then we have to see position of Venus, position of Mercury, whether it is in front of camera or behind the cameras. But everywhere this Rahu is playing very important role. This is the plus side of Rahu. What is the negative side of Rahu? Rahu is hallucination. Rahu is illusion. Rahu is mrigajal. You see water is here. If you are in the desert, you see water is here, you run after getting the water, and when you go there, you don't find any water. This is Rahu. Rahu prefers to stay in shadow. Rahu prefers to stay in andhera, what you call as, where no light is there. Okay, so Rahu doesn't need any type of light, because Rahu is more survived in shadow only, because it is a shadow planet. Rahu is very comfortable in all dirty places. That is why he is more comfortable with Saturn also, because Saturn also rules all the dirty places where all the dirt and waste is thrown. So Saturn rules over there. So if Rahu is there, Rahu is also more comfortable there. So even people working in this waste department, or people working in any class 4 people, you see Rahu and Saturn more activated in their chart. Whether it is a class 4, whether it is an engineering level, then you have to see Mars position, you have to see Jupiter position and all that, you know. But this is the fruits you see, that media person also you see in this, and you see a person working in another field also, Rahu person. So now we will come again to Rahu, that in transit, what this Rahu will do? Whenever Rahu transit from fourth bhava of Lagna, I will tell you the major houses first. So whenever Rahu is in your fourth house, it will disturb the peace of house. If you are planning to buy any house, and if transit Rahu is in your fourth bhava, and even though Mars is aspecting, you will get some or other hindrance in paperwork. This is the fruit given by Rahu. Now this Rahu, if is in own sign, if in transit this Rahu is in own sign, or you can say in Mercury sign, then fruits will vary. It will give its karakatva to the native, but late it will give, not immediately. So fourth bhava Rahu is not considered very good in transit. Which bhavas are considered good for Rahu? That is, all apoklim houses are considered good. That is, third house, sixth house is considered good, 10th house is considered good, and 11th house is considered good for Rahu. So whenever in transit, if beneficiary Rahu is transiting over 3rd, 6th, 10th or 11th bhava, it will give fruits which are not accepted by society. I will clear it here. I will go in more deep. See, if person is fighting for any case in the court, if Rahu is in 6th bhava in transit, so even though that person is wrong, but he will be proved right in the court. You know, asatya ki bhi jeet ho jati hai. If Rahu is transiting from 11th house, aspecting the fifth house, or if Rahu is transiting from third house, even though person is having unofficial relations or person is having extramarital relations, he will never be caught in the society. Many a times we see that. That doesn't mean that everybody has this yoga. This is just I am giving an example. Or even though person is lying with the friends with anything, any topic or any issues, even though he is a liar, even though he is lying, but people will believe him and the truth will be hid. So this is the another bad aspect of Rahu. The person who is getting benefit, he will be happy for that period only. But as soon as Rahu transit will go from there, or even for people who are having natal Rahu over there, as soon as Ashubha planet aspect comes on it, or Ashubha dasha, antar dasha will come, his lie will come out. Always there is a winning of truth. We should never forget that. So Rahu is illusion. Rahu will show, now you are having everything in your hand, now you enjoy the life. And once person start enjoying the life, Rahu suddenly gives downfall to the native. So many natives we see, they go for suicide, because once they are so habitual of getting name, fame, or once they are so habitual of enjoying the material life, fruits, glamorous life, or enjoying wealth, and suddenly if downfall comes, or suddenly if manhani or loss of respect comes in its dasha antar, then person is going to poisoning or person is suiciding. So many charts, so many times we are seeing this. So Rahu also rules over death. So for that again many placements and many transit we have to see. Not only this, but Rahu is a key factor for suicide also, for poisoning also, for snake bite also, for any insect bite also. Rahu plays very important role. If Rahu is in 8th house in anybody's chart, they should not take any medicine without doctor's prescription or without doctor's advice. Self-medication is always dangerous for them. They may get reaction of that medicine. So it is always better to consult a doctor and take a medicine. So this is one of the effect of Rahu. But if it is having Shubha aspect of Jupiter, then result may vary. So one should not go into superstitions of that, or one should not stick to the same dicta. See, always one dicta is written, another dicta is written, third dicta is written. So we have to correlate each dicta with each other. We cannot stick to any one dicta of this. So Rahu in Rahu Mahadasha, if Lagnesh Dasha is there, it will go good. In Rahu Mahadasha, Rahu is friend to Saturn, Rahu is friend to Mercury, Rahu is comfortable with Venus. So all these Antar Dasha in Rahu Dasha will be good, will go good to the native. If at all these planets are again Yog Karak in that chart, we have to see that also. But other than that, at least out of 100, 50 to 60% fruits will be gained in Rahu Dasha and Mercury Antar Dasha, Venus Antar Dasha, Saturn Antar Dasha. So Rahu will give occult studies to the native. Most of the cases I have seen in my life, that since I started this astrology study in my class also, with my classmates also I saw it, and in my study also I saw it, the whoever people have started astrology study, or whoever people have been in occult sciences, they have been in this field सिंस देर राहु दशा और देर केतु दशा और अंतर और अंतर दशा ऑफ राहु और केतु और अंतर दशा और मेन दशा ऑफ एर्थ लॉर्ड और समवेयर और अदर राहु केतु इज कनेक्टेड. इवन स्टडी ऑल्सो एंड इवन स्टार्टिंग द स्टडी ऑल्सो एंड इवन स्टार्टिंग द predictions also. So while giving predictions also, if Rahu is in your second house, the person is getting Vacha Siddhi. But this person will never, should never utter a single negative word. Otherwise also any astrologer should not utter a negative word while giving the predictions. But particularly Rahu in second bhav will always give Vacha Siddhi to the native. Or even though person is not in occult, many a times whatever these people speak comes to be true. So this is a another result of Rahu. So now Rahu Dasha we already talked about. So at present Rahu is transiting in Leo and it will go in Cancer next year. So now till August Jupiter and Rahu are together. So everybody should follow the rules and regulations of the society. If at all it has got Shubha aspect, people will be beneficiary to get the good results of this Yuti. I wish all of you all the best, and next session I will be discussing about Ketu, and then I will discuss about remedies of Rahu and Ketu. So by that time I say you bye bye. Thank you so much.